Hi, welcome to this video. It's about during the holiday time, and I wanted to share some really cool things that I picked up during the holiday season. So first, I'll start with makeup, and I picked up this really wonderful mascara from CoverGirl. I got the Plumpify Blast Pro mascara. I got a waterproof mascara and it's very black. I haven't opened it yet, so this is going to be like my first time, but well, maybe I'll just open it later. But I got this mascara with this really, really cool wand, and I think how it works is you twirl the mascara as you hold it by the roots, or you hold it on your lashes, and it's a way to apply the mascara, and I'm really excited about this, and it has a nice packaging. And I picked up a CoverGirl Lip Perfection Jumbo Gloss Balm in the shade Ballet Twist 205. I haven't opened up this one yet either, but I'm really excited I got it. And I picked up some eyeshadows, excuse me. I picked up Swish Chocolate. I thought this would be a really nice light brow powder, or to use like a eyeliner, but it's basically an eyeshadow. And I picked up a CoverGirl Singles Eyeshadow Quad in Silver Lining, and also Platina. And I haven't opened these up yet either. And I picked up a Rimmel London Moisture Renew lipstick in the shade Coral Garden, and it came with a free clear lip liner. I think it's clear, I'm not sure. And so on for clothes, I picked up this heavy duty plaid top. It's actually a heavy duty men's plaid top. I wore it on Saturday, and it can be worn like a jacket for a woman or for a normal men's shirt. But I thought this would be a good unisex shirt, and it's nice as a jacket, and it wraps around and keeps me warm. And I picked up this plaid shirt also. It's not as heavy duty as the other one, but hopefully it'll work and it will seem ladylike, and same as this one. I was worried that they wouldn't seem ladylike, but I hope they'll work, and they're really heavy duty. And I also picked up this jacket from Old Navy also. It's just red and gray plaids. And for books, I thought the holiday time would be a really great way to share a vegan lifestyle, vegetarian lifestyle. So I'll share some of those. But first, I got some books at Barnes & Noble. This is titled Little Ways to Keep Calm and Carry On. It's for worrying, it's for managing worry, anxiety, and fear. So I got that. And I got this book, The Freaking Book of Everything Irish. And it has some Irish recipes. And it has like these word definitions. I've never heard of them before. And I thought it would be like an Irish culture book. But I guess it has all these different types of Irish words or Irish slang words. So that was pretty cool. I thought it would be nice to learn about the Irish culture. I got these on bargain price also. And from my local Habitat for Humanity store, I picked up some books. They're actually gifts. All the books that I have here, they're gifts. I guess they're gifts to myself or whatever, but anyways, this book is on Prague. It's just a travel book, and it has some nice pictures to look at. Hopefully one day I'll go to Prague. It's far away from where I live, but oh well. So this book is on Prague. I thought the pictures would be really great. And if I never make it there, then oh well. So anyways, this is the oats, peas, beans, and barley cookbook. These are about $1 from my local Habitat for Humanity store, and has some totally awesome recipes. Ever since I became interested in vegetarian vegan food, I was really into the old-fashioned cookbooks because I thought those had like really savory, traditional, mouth-watering, table happy recipes. By table happy, I mean like how they make the eyes and the stomach and the heart feel happy because they're vegetarian and they just look so wonderful and so delicious and heartwarming. So I thought a bunch of old books would have those type of recipes, but maybe it's just because they've been around for a long time. But yeah, this is a nice one. Even though I'm gluten-free, I can always substitute the ingredients that aren't gluten-free. So anyways, this one is called Fast Vegetarian Feast, and I love the traditional cookbooks that feature wonderful vegetarian foods, and I love the spirit of the vegetarian platter foods. I just think it's totally amazing, and it makes the heart quite happy. And I picked up A Taste of Heaven and Earth, and this one has some really great recipes. I don't think it's all vegan or gluten-free, but I can also make the recipes vegan, gluten-free. And I also picked up this lovely one, Scandinavian Cooking. Classic cooking from Sweden, Norway, Denmark, and Finland. I thought this would give me some really great ideas. And like I said, I can just always substitute the recipes and make them vegan, vegetarian, or gluten-free. So that's my advice, or my holiday advice, for you. And that's all I have for now. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful, happy, glorious, heartwarming holiday season. And hopefully I'll see you next time. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.